Hello students, today we are going to start with the second chapter of Beehive textbook, that is The Sound of Music. Part 1, Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it by Deborah Cole. The title itself is very interesting. Here the author says, Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. Now we all wonder, we are confused. How can you listen to sound when you can't hear? So this is something we will discover, that how Evelyn Glennie was able to listen to sound although she could not hear. Now before we proceed with the chapter, let's discuss. God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Someone has commented this about Evelyn. He says that although God took away her hearing power, she was impaired, but He gave her extraordinary thing, and that was the sense of feeling she could feel very deeply. Far more deeply than the normal people. And that is why she was able to express music so beautifully, so well. She plays different percussion instruments like xylophone, drums. The story of Evelyn Glennie is a motivational story. It inspires all of us to overcome our physical disabilities and achieve our dreams and goals, just like Evelyn did. The scene is of the train platform. It is underground and there is a huge rush at the platform. People are pushing each other to get the way. There is a small thin girl. It is Evelyn. Evelyn is standing at the railway platform waiting for the train. And just as she feels the vibrations of the approaching train, she realizes that the train is about to come. She gets nervous and excited. This is the train that will take Evelyn to London. She is going to London to learn music, as she had got admission in the Royal Academy of Music. Right now, Evelyn is in Scotland. So that is why Evelyn is nervous, because she is leaving Scotland for London. And she is excited also, because she is doing something that she always dreamt of. She is going to the Royal Academy of Music to learn music. Evelyn is 17 years of age. She is a teenager and she is fresh from a Scottish farm. As Evelyn is from Scotland, which has more of farms and countryside, so she has not seen fast life. That is why she is nervous, and the writer says that she is fresh from a Scotland farm. Evelyn could not hear, and this was a bigger challenge for her. Moving from a rural area to a fast life was a smaller change. Evelyn faced a much bigger challenge. That was her inability to hear. Slowly, slowly, she started losing the power of hearing. One day, she was absolutely deaf. Isabel Glennie is the name of Evelyn's mother. Evelyn's mother, Isabel, recollects one incident when Evelyn was 8 years old. She says that Evelyn was waiting for her turn to play the piano, but when her name was called out, she did not respond. And her mother realized that Evelyn did not respond to her name. That means she did not hear her name being called out. As Evelyn lost her sense of hearing in phases, it was a gradual process. In the beginning, when she could hear partially, she could manage to hide this disability from her friends and teachers. When Evelyn was 11 years old, her marks has started deteriorating. The headmistress requested parents to take Evelyn to the doctor. When the doctor checked upon Evelyn, he found out that Evelyn had lost the sense of hearing. The doctor advised Evelyn's parents that they should get hearing aids for her. He also suggested that Evelyn should be sent to school for the deaf children. When Evelyn discovered that she could not hear, her world became colorless. Although Evelyn got such a shocking news, still she was determined and she did not want to give up. Yes, Evelyn was passionate about music. This news also did not break her. She was determined to live life like normal people and follow her interest in music. As Evelyn was passionate about music, this news also did not break her. She was determined to live life like normal people and follow her interest in music. When Evelyn saw a girl playing the xylophone, she wanted to play it too. Now on one hand, Evelyn's teacher discouraged her because they knew that she could not hear and hearing was an important part of music. But Ron Forbes saw that Evelyn was very passionate about music, and so he decided that he would teach Evelyn to feel music. He took two large drums and tuned them to different notes. Drums are musical instruments, and he tuned them. He tuned each drum to different notes, so the sound produced by the drums was different. Then he told Evelyn, "Don't try to listen through ears." He said that try to sense it. Try to feel the music some other way. Now, as Ron Forbes had tuned both the drums to different notes, the upper part of Evelyn's body above the waist could feel the higher notes of the drum, and lower part of her body, the part down from the waist, could feel the lower notes of drum. This is how Evelyn can listen to sound, although she cannot hear. She can sense different notes in different parts of her body. Once Evelyn overcome the hurdle, she started sensing the different sounds through the different parts of her body. She progressed in her career. So Evelyn turned the United Kingdom and performed with a youth orchestra. By the time Evelyn reached the age of 16 years, she had decided to make music her life. Evelyn gave an audition for the admission to the Royal Academy of Music, and her score was the highest in the history of the academy. She had achieved all the top awards by the time she had completed her 3-year course at the Royal Academy of Music. If anyone says that Evelyn has done something great, she does not acknowledge that. She is very humble and down to earth. Evelyn says that two important things for success are, firstly, hard work, and secondly, aim. She says that if you work hard and you can have an aim, a target which you have to achieve, then you will definitely achieve it. Thank you.